Okay, so let's say before you actually link to the content in your course, you need to edit it. Then you need to come into My Media and hover over this and choose Edit. Now, I highly recommend that you do this before you actually link to the content, because this is going to allow you to trim off the beginning and the end, which is usually the kind of parts where you were setting up your camera or things didn't work out quite as well in the beginning. And then you can also cut different parts of a video, and then you can also edit your captions. Now, remember, all of your videos have to be captioned. The good thing about Yuja is it actually captions your video for you, and then you just have to fix some of the words. It takes a while for these captions to show up, though, so just be ready for that. Even after it's already kind of rendered and it shows up in My Media, it might take a while for those captions to work. So I highly recommend that maybe you start working on your second video and your kind of script. I always keep like a bullet list of the things I want to cover, and I put it on a sticky note right in front of me as I'm recording so that it's just a reminder to me of the things that I needed to cover for that video. So let's go over a couple of things. I can't go over everything with you, but this has a lot of different cool features, so I'll go over them. Like I'll tell you they're there, and then you just need to play with it. Okay, so over here, this is what we call a playhead, and this is going to advance the video and go forward in time. And this is your audio layer, and then your primary video, which is, for me, my screen, which is here. And this is the secondary, which is me, and this flattering little screenshot here. All right, so let's start talk about trimming first. So this is trim the start. So let's say this part I kind of coughed, or I was just getting my microphone ready or clearing my throat, and I want to trim that part off. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit trim and then pull this out, the gray part out, and just get rid of that part of it. Now you can also play this so you can see which parts you want to trim. So then let's say I wanted to trim the end. For some reason, let's say I wanted to get rid of this part here. And you can see the spaces where where there's a gap because I wasn't talking. So sometimes that's easier to look at to see where you should cut it, is right in those kind of gaps. All right, so that's trimming the beginning and trimming the end of this. And if I go up to the settings, you can choose to preview the cut. So the other thing to do is cut things. So let's say right here, there's this little spike. And I can't show you the video because I'm recording this tutorial at the same time, but assume that you've watched the video and you realize this little spike right here is you clearing your throat or coughing, etc. You're going to need to cut that. Now, it's really important that you pay attention to where this playhead is. So I'm going to put this right before that cough, and you have to move that before you actually hit cut or else it won't work. So I'm going to hit cut. And as you can see, when I move down to the timeline, and that's where we're at right here, it's going to have this gray line showing, okay, where do you want me to cut? So I'm going to cut on the other side of this throat clearing. And all of these gray areas are basically telling you that in the final edit of this video, all of those pieces will be gone. If you need to change the length of those, you can grab this little black arrow here to adjust the cuts or the trims. And there you go. Now, a couple other things you can do, you can undo anything that you've already done. This icon represents the ability to add a slide or an image, so make sure that you're following copyright rules, but for the most part, because you're using it in teaching, you should be able to use any images. This is where you can overlay a video as you're still talking. So if you wanted to do that, you can. Just know that the video has to be an MP4. If you have the video in a different format like .mov, you can contact the D2L administrator or marketing, because we all have software that can convert video from one format to another. And you just need to say, I need this video converted to an MP4. All right. Over here is where you can do image tools. Like if you took an image, you can also do a watermark, or you can do a blur or blackout region, which if you're filming something that might have FERPA information, make sure that you're using these blur or blackout regions to cover that information up. Last but not least, you can do a text overlay, so you can add some text. Like I do that a lot when I'm telling students a website to go to, because it's really hard for them to see as you type in a tiny URL bar. And so I would just put the address down here. And you can also tell it, you know, where it should live and all that kind of stuff. So just play with those features. And the last, you can zoom in and zoom out of this timeline. So if you really want to get detailed with it, you can zoom in that way. And there we go. So the last thing I wanted to show you is how to actually edit your captions. So you can see this closed captioning button here. And this is where it's going to show you all the captions for this video. And it's going to tell you the time that this caption is popping up. So mine's a little bit off. It's not showing all of my captions. Just because, again, I'm recording this tutorial video as I was recording this Yuja video. And it kind of got a little wonky in there. So it shouldn't happen with you. But this is showing you when the caption will appear. And as you can see that it automatically added your caption for you. You just need to fix all the different things or the quirks or the words. And again, you can play it and see what you said and fix it here. So I would just go through. You should see now still going or showing exactly what you're seeing in your. See how this says Toriel? It's like an elf name. So let's go ahead and put tutorial video. And it seems okay to me. Oh, not rectally. Oh my God. Going to really. No. We're going to. I don't know what that was. So I would have to watch this video, but I'm pretty sure it wasn't rectally. So, all right. If you need to add a caption for some reason, it left one out. You can add it here and you can adjust times here and refresh things, or you can trash a caption if you want to. As you can see, there are two pages. Ah, there's my first page. So this looks pretty good. Well, I'm not actually going to go through this, but that's how you can edit your captions. So when you are done editing your video, you've trimmed it, you've cut it, you've added your content, you've changed your captions, then you're going to want to hit the save button up here, and it'll say specify how you want to apply the edits. Do you want to create an edited version of that video so that you have the raw video? I would recommend that. And it says the existing captions may not be valid for the edited video due to a change in its play length. So this is because I was trimming the beginning and the end. So that's where you're going to need to come up here. And like, I should have deleted this caption that, or this very last caption that was probably in this end area. Most of the time you won't actually be talking during those, but like for the cuts and things you will. So again, you should be playing it the entire time, which I couldn't do. All right. So, this is re-request auto captions to be created for the new video. That's going to overwrite what you just did with your captions. So another thing you can do is edit and trim it and cut it and do all that stuff first, and then have it do the captions again. Because if you add a video from somebody else, you're going to need captions for that as well. So you can have it recaption it. For me right now, I'm going to go ahead and do copy existing caption file and leave it at that. So you can look through all these. There's a transcript so people can download it in plain text or PDF. And I'm going to go ahead and just save this as a new video, not replace the existing video, just in case I need to go back. Okay, so it's going to do the same processing that it did the first time we recorded this video. So it'll probably take 2 or 3 minutes. And once that's done, I can publish it, have it show up in the top level of my course, and I can link to that in my content area.